There used to be a song which wondered how you're going to keep them down on the farm after they've seen Broadway, but it turns out that's no problem at all. A lot of people are staying away from Broadway these days, and they have been for years. Part of the problem is Broadway itself. The neighborhood around Times Square looks more like a red light district than the gay white way of old, and many suburbanites who used to be theater buffs have switched to television. But in spite of dwindling attendance and soaring production costs, people still open Broadway shows and occasionally get rich in the process. The latest hit is A Little Night Music. The show cost more than $600,000, but by the time the curtain went up, about $300,000 worth of advance tickets had already been sold. The fellow who wrote the words and music is taking all this in stride, and why not? He's Stephen Sondheim, and he's been the words and or music man for some of the biggest hits of the last 15 years. But while the new show has the critics gaga, it is not quite like Broadway smash hits of old. For one thing, you don't come out of the theater whistling the big numbers. When you sit down to write a show, do you make a conscious effort to write hit songs? Or
No. I've had very few hit songs, actually. They generally tend to step out on their own if they're going to become hits. I don't know what makes a hit song. Usually it's a recording artist that makes it. I know that West Side Story came out in 1957, and to a man, the critics and the public, too, said, oh, it's a very exciting show, but unfortunately you can't hum any of the songs. So for 4 years, there were exactly two singles made from the songs in West Side Story. Dinah Shore made a recording of Tonight, and Johnny Mathis made a recording of Maria, and nobody else recorded a single song because they thought, yes, the score is very effective in the theater, but you can't hum it, and it's a... The movie came out. 1961, and there were many hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of advertising done, which meant getting disc jockeys to play the tunes on the air, and suddenly everybody could hum all the tunes, and suddenly there were a lot of recordings of Tonight, and a lot of recordings of Maria, and a lot of recordings of Somewhere. Same music, musical taste hadn't gotten that much more sophisticated. What makes a song hummable, a word that I don't like, but a lot of people talk about, there are two things that make a song hummable. One is if you've heard it before, that is, if it's vaguely plagiarized. And the other thing is if you hear it enough. If you play a song, or if you play the Berg Violin Concerto enough times, you can absolutely hum it. There's plenty of so-called melody in the Berg Violin Concerto. No, not on one hearing. It's very hard to get. It's very thorny and difficult music for you the first time around. Well, that was true of the score of West Side. I'm only picking West Side because everybody said how difficult Leonard Bernstein's music was to hum. It wasn't at all. It was very hummable as soon as they heard it enough times.
Do you expect that to happen to any of the pieces from...
I would love it, sure, if they hear it enough.
What's your favorite out of this new show?
Favorite song? I like a lot of things. There's a song that Glynis Johns sings in the second act that's very sweet and simple called Send in the Clowns. And there's a very angry song called The Miller's Son, which comes near the end of the show, that I like a lot. And
could you play some of the clown song?
Sure, it's here on the piano. I'd be happy to.
Isn't it rich? Are we a pair? Me here at last on the ground, you in midair. Send in the clowns. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps tearing around, one who can't move. Where are the clowns? Send in the clowns. Just when I'd stopped opening doors, finally knowing the one that I wanted was yours, making my entrance again with my usual flair, sure of my life.
No one clown. Don't bother, they're here.
One thing about a little night music would probably even please President Nixon. Nobody takes his or her clothes off on stage, and nowadays that presumably qualifies the show as wholesome family entertainment, in spite of the fact that the plot line involves quite a bit of adultery. Hughes Rudd, CBS News, New York.
Short of my life, no one.
Try to forgive me.